हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एनालॉग आईएएस प्रीलिम्स हाई यील्डिंग सीरीज फॉर प्रीलिम्स 2020 एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेस वीडियो इज द एशियाटिक लायन कंजर्वेशन प्रोजेक्ट. द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ एशियाटिक लायन कंजर्वेशन प्रोजेक्ट लाइज इन द फैक्ट दैट देर आर ओनली सेवरल हंड्रेड एशियाटिक लायंस इन द वाइल्ड एंड दे ओनली लिव इन द गिर फॉरेस्ट ऑफ आर कंट्री. सो दिस इज एन एरिया दैट इज स्मॉलर दैन ग्रेटर लंडन एज वेल. So the Asiatic lions are slightly smaller than the African lions, and we'll be looking at more details in the upcoming slides. So the news is MoFSI, or the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, approved the project to conserve Asiatic lions for the next three financial years till 2021, starting from 2018. One of the flagship program that is central for conservation of endangered species of the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is the Species Recovery Program taken up by the Ministry. So just like any successful policy, without the involvement of local community and without a multi-sectoral agency for disease control and veterinary care, any conservation project will not be successful. So same approach is being followed even for Asiatic lion conservation project as well. Now here is some work that you can do. What is the name of the tribe that is involved in conservation of Gir lions? Please comment this in the comment box below along with the question that I'll be asking in the end. Another important concept is the landscape approach in conserving this lions. So what is this concept of landscape approach? Many global problems such as poverty, food security, climate change, water scarcity, deforestation, everything are interlinked. For example, lifting people out of poverty can increase consumption and drive climate change. Expanding agriculture can put this particular conservation efforts in a threat. Expanding agriculture can also increase water scarcity and drive habitat loss. So the people who suggest this landscape approach are the ones who argue that the problems are interconnected, and therefore the approach to solve these problems should also be coordinated. Unless and until we address them together, we will not be able to ensure a final objective of conservation and sustainability. So such an approach is followed even in Asiatic lion conservation project. Now here are some facts about the Asiatic lion. The scientific names are not important for UPSC prelims, but if you want to know, it is Panthera leo persica. You can use this picture to learn certain important facts. One of the most distinguished feature of Asiatic lion is the longitudinal fold of the skin running along its belly. If you can have a look at this, the foldings of the skin are the distinctive features to identify Asiatic lion. Obviously, since it is very important, it is placed in the Schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act, CITES Appendix Index 1. And the fact is, Asiatic lion is not critically endangered as per IUCN. This is one of the most important facts that you have to remember. It is just endangered, not critically endangered. So at this moment, Gir National Park is the only place where you would find Asiatic lions. Now, another important fact with respect to conservation is both the state government and the union government are involved. Now, conservation efforts are not just restricted to union government or state government alone. It is the combined effort of both the state and the union government. In most of the conservation efforts, both the state governments and the central governments are involved. And because of this, the population of Asiatic lions has increased to over 500 from around 50 in the late 1890s. Previously, many kings and British officers used to hunt Asiatic lions, and ever since, there have been increased awareness that environmental sustainability is at stake if we remove predators from the ecosystem, and therefore conservation efforts were restored. Now recently, we have had a particular virus called the canine distemper virus, which has been killing Asiatic lions. As many as 23 lions were killed by this virus since 2013. another important parasitic disease. It is not a viral disease or a bacterial disease. It is a parasitic disease which requires a host. So the ticks are the host in this case. The name of the disease is babesiosis. So babesiosis and canine distemper virus are some of the major disease causing reasons for the deaths of many Asiatic lions. Also, we found that Kuno Palpur Wildlife Sanctuary has enough conditions to ensure the sustainability of Asiatic lions, and therefore Supreme Court has directed an expert committee to relocate this animal to Kuno Palpur Wildlife Sanctuary. Similarly, we also had a cheetah reintroduction program. The government was considering the same wildlife sanctuary for reintroduction of cheetah as well. Now this becomes a problematic issue because we cannot have two different predators in the same ecosystem. It will lead to loss of life, not just for those predators, but also there will be imbalance created in that particular ecosystem. Now let us have a look at these questions. Consider the following statements about Asiatic lion. Asiatic lion is found only in India. Yes, this statement is right at this moment. The population of Asiatic lions has increased to over 500, which has been around 50 in 1890s. We have already discussed this. The conservation efforts of both the state as well as the central government have ensured that the population increased in the case of Asiatic lions. So, two only is the answer. Now, with respect to question number two, please pause the video and try to comment the answer in the comment section below along with an explanation. In this concept, you have to understand the importance of the term vermin. Why am I talking about vermins? So please comment your answer in the context of this question. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching it. Stay tuned for more videos.